हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू टुडे सेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द सोशल मूवमेंट एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एजिटेशन। सो लेट्स बिगिन। व्हाट इज सोशल मूवमेंट? सोशल मूवमेंट इज रिफर्स टू एनी ब्रॉड सोशल अलायंस ऑफ पीपुल दोज आर कनेक्टेड थ्रू देयर शेयर्ड इंटरेस्ट इन ब्लॉकिंग और अफेक्टिंग सोशल चेंज। The objective of social movement are to create or to resist change or to provide political voice to those otherwise disenfranchised. The term social movement is conceptualized by the political and sociologist Charles Tilly. He defined social movement as a major vehicle for ordinary people's participation in public politics. According to Doug Adam and David Snow, the social movement should contain four elements. Those are a collective action, an orientation towards change, a degree of organization, a degree of temporal continuity, and institutional non-institutional action. Now let's discuss the characteristics of social movement. Social movement is a pre-planned, concentrated action. It doesn't happen haphazardly. It is social, political, and cultural conflict to bring out changes. It is always counter movement by a counter ideology. Social movement can be revolutionary movement to reform ultimate change of the society. Then let's discuss the stages, four stages of the social movement. Those are emergence. Emergence is a stage when social movement emerges. And coalescence is the period when social movement became popularized. Then we have bureaucratization. In period of bureaucratization, social movement become violent and agitational and formalizing. And last one is decline stage. In this stage, either social movement become success or maybe half success or failure. Rather, it is conceptualized and go through the stream. So let's now discuss types of social movement. Basically, there are five types of social movement. We will discuss one by one. Those are general goal social movement. It is to develop egalitarian social relationship. Reformative social movement is for reform the society. And revolutionary social movement, it is complete change of the society. And we have old social movement are social, political, economical, and it was happened before 1990. Then we have new social movement. New social movement was started on second half of the 21st century. And these are feminist movement, LGBT movement, environmental movement, and peace movement. Feminist movement means the movement of feminine gender to get equal status as compared to male dominance. So they want to destroy the patriarchal norms. They want to destroy the gender discrimination, and they want to treat as like men. Now LGBT. LGBT means lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender. These people also demand equal status as a citizen and they wants to live with dignitary life. So they demand constitutional safeguard and provision to live as a equal citizen with others. And we have environmental movement. It is basically against the capitalism and industrialization to protect the environment and climate from all type of pollution. And last one is peace movement. That is to ban all type of war and establishment of peace in the world. So all these are types of social movement. Now let's discuss what happened in India. India was a country unity in diversity, and there is lots of diversity we found. In India there was barna system, casteism, gender discrimination and religion communalism. So when Buddha was revolting against the barna system, people support him because he saw the path of equality, liberty and justice. So he gave the three principles of life. Those are Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha. And he propagated the ideology of Arya Ashtanga Marga. So basically Shudra support him, who those are deprived section, who those had not rights. So this movement became success. After that we found in modern India Jyotirao Phule, who founded Satya Sadhak Samaj in 1873 and spread scientific temperament and realized the life of self-respect. He also submitted the proposal before British and pressurized the Hunter Commission to open school, and even he first of all opened school for women, Shudras and for untouchable. So his movement in 18th century was successful. So it is a best example of social movement. After that we looked Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, who formed Depressed Class Federation, Scheduled Caste Federation, Indian Labour Party, Republican Party of India, and this journey led to him to write Indian Constitution, and he became chairman of drafting commission and he wrote the Indian Constitution. By this we get lots of rights, and originally Indian Constitution had 395 articles, and maximum articles are in favor of downtrodden people. So Indian Constitution was a lengthiest constitution in his time. Let's discuss the silent features of Indian Constitution. It is federal government, parliamentary form of government. It has a beautiful preamble. It has fundamental rights, directive state principle, and independent judiciary, partly rigid and partly flexible. Lots of silent feature in Indian Constitution. So it is a source of constitution which is adopted from different source. This constitution gives lots of right. When Babasaheb Ambedkar himself told that if anybody asks what is most important in Indian Constitution, that is Babasaheb Ambedkar says Article 32. It is constitutional remedy, rights to constitutional remedy. If anybody loses his rights, he can appeal through district court to Supreme Court. So these articles is very important, and Babasaheb Ambedkar says it is very heart and very soul to Indian Constitution. And there is fundamental rights for every citizen of the country. So in fundamental rights, right to freedom is a right which is unique and it provides to freedom of speech, expression, belief, faith and creation of association, establishment of organization, propagation of education and ideology and agitation. Through Article 19, we saw in modern India many revolutionary doing agitation like Kansi Ram who founded DS4, BSP, Bamsev, and we now see Vaman Mesram, API, Mayawati, Chandrasekhar Ravan, and many youth leaders in Odisha doing revolution, educational, cultural, political, social. We founded lots of social movement. At last, when Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar submit the Indian Constitution, he told that however good may be a constitution, who those are implementing it, those are not good. If those are bad, it will be proved bad. And however may be bad a constitution, who those are implementing are good, it will be proved good. And it is proved that Indian government, who those are in government, who those are in implementation, they are not good. Therefore, we found every day women are getting raped. Students are, farmers are doing suicide. Brutal atrocity happens on the basis of caste, religion, gender, etc. Tribal people are becoming segregated. So we have lots of problem in our country, and therefore Kansi Ram once said that शासितों पे जुल्म होती है, शासकों पे नहीं, इसलिए शासक जमात बनना है. इवन अम्बेडकर ऑल्सो टोल्ड दैट जाओ अपने घर के दीवार पे लिख दो कि हमें शासक करती जमात बनना है. सो आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट एवरीबडी सिंसियरली प्लीज एंड प्लीज टू थिंक टू बी रूलिंग क्लास ऑफ ओडिशा एंड देन वी कैन remove, eradicate, annihilate our problem. So that's all from my side. Thank you very much. Jai Bhim.